गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। हेलो,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। अरे
सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लर्निंग आउटकम एट अ एलिमेंट्री लेवल एंड अ सेकेंडरी लेवल इन मैथमेटिक्स एंड वेरी ब्रीफली हियर वी विल टॉक जनरली व्हाट इज द लर्निंग आउटकम फर्स्ट। So can anybody tell me that what do you understand by the learning outcome? What is learning outcome as per your conception about the term? What do you understand? Learning outcome, what is that learning outcome? Anybody? Because you have some teaching experience also during your internship program, first phase of internship program.
Sir, my opinion is when we set an objective before we deliver a lesson, after the lesson deliberation, we check whether the objective is achieved or not. My opinion is learning outcome that the objective is achieved or not.
Okay, Asutosh. Others, anybody, can you tell what is the learning outcome? Ansuman, are you here? Ansuman? Ansuman? I think he is not here. Okay. Then, Asutosh Panda?
Yes, sir. I am here, sir.
Achha, achha. So, what is the learning outcome, Ansuman?
Sir, the wholesome experience we get from
it's
learning different objects.
It's an experience. Okay. I think Bibhu was trying to say something. Bibhu? Yes.
Sir,
what?
For example.
Yes.
Sir, for example, in a computer, we give it to input, then the processing is the process is going on, and output is come. So in the learning process, we gain some information, some data, and after the process.
लर्निंग आउटकम। ओके, यू हैव ट्राइड वेरी वेल। ओके, बट थोड़ा सा दैट रिक्वायर्स मॉडिफिकेशन। एनीबडी एल्स? आशुतोष पंडा, आशुतोष आर यू हियर?
सर,
हाँ, क्या है ये लर्निंग आउटकम?
सर, लर्निंग आउटकम इज द रिजल्ट एट द गेन फ्रॉम द लर्निंग, माने हमें लर्निंग आउटकम।
अच्छा, सो आई विल टेक वन मोर रिस्पॉन्स टू होम। लीजा रानी, यस सर। लीजा, व्हाट इज दैट लर्निंग आउटकम?
Sir, after the end of any course of introduction or learning process, a student able to know, understand or apply any of the experience known as learning outcomes.
So you are knowing the things, but why you are silent? Always I should not ask by the name that you should reply. You should come forward voluntarily, okay? So, see, whenever we think of teaching learning in a classroom, okay, not only in the classroom, means the teaching learning situation, teaching learning environment, whenever we are thinking of. So, before the teaching learning starts, you make some objective, means through your teaching learning engagement, what you want to achieve. Like that, we used to write a learning objective with the support of action verb by the Bloom taxonomy, like that, and we write a learning objective like at the end of this lesson, student will be able to know about the triangle. Knowing how means they will define, they will illustrate, they will be able to illustrate, they will be able to draw different type of a triangle, hai na? They will be able to identify different type of a triangle, compare and contrast different type of a triangle. So these are the learning objectives that I have written with the help of action verb, compare and contrast, define, draw, from the Bloom taxonomy. So these are the objective, means you want to get those things after your teaching will be over. So this is the one part. Another part is that when you will go to the class, you will have a certain objective that you have framed while preparing for the class. Because during the planning, we have seen that we have a three phase of the teaching learning process. One is the planning. Within the planning, there are the different phases. Then the execution. We execute whatever we have planned. And then we try to get a feedback. So, there are the three phases. And these phases are cyclic in nature. So, let it be. So, we have planned the objective. That these objective I want to achieve out of my teaching. Then what happens? You will go to the class and you will do something. Doing something means either you will use a lecture, or you will demonstrate, or you will engage them in observation, or you will engage them in experimentation, like that. Variety of methods of teaching of a different type of concepts are there. And the methods of teaching will be based upon what kind of objective you want, whatever what kind of objective you have set, what is the content, who are the children, what are the situation. So, by considering all those things, you have done something. That is the teacher's work, means what you are doing. That is a teaching strategy, teaching methods, engagement methods, what you are doing. But after, out of your doing, what the children will be able to do. If you have finished your doing, if you have finished the class, so after that class, what the children will be able to do. Suppose that you have engaged them in a observation. So, after observation, what the children will do? So, what will happen? Whatever you will do, so that is your part, the teaching learning engagement. And after that doing, what the children will do? That part is, we term at as a learning outcome. You have finished your doing. So, after finishing your work, what the children will be able to do? Okay. So, that is the learning outcome. But there is one question which always comes in the student mind. Sir, then what is the difference between the learning objective and the learning outcome? How many of you have got the this type of a question? What is the learning objective and what is the learning outcome? What is the difference? How many of you got this question? Because both looks same. Yes, anybody? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Sir, see, I am very clearly saying that if you like to be a silent like that, so I have to ask multiple time, then I will not like to teach in the online mode. I used to ask question, I am talking to you, but nobody is bothering to respond. If this is the situation, I will not take the class, I will tell the principal, sir. What are you saying?
Sir, learning objective is basically...
No. So, that is the secondary objective. That is the secondary question now. I am telling that why I have to repeatedly ask and you are...
मैं पूछ रहा हूँ... नेटवर्क के वजह से थोड़ा लेट रिप्लाई चला जा रहा है.
ठीक है, आपके पास नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम होगा. आपके पास नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम होगा. सम ऑफ यू may have been facing the network problem. Majority of you may be facing the network problem, but all of you may not be facing the network problem. That I am damn sure. All of you may not be facing.
Sir, actually, mic off रहता है ना, phone करने के बोलने में 1-2 second, 3 second लग जाता है.
It is a matter of 30 second, Anshuman. 1 second, what do you think that in 1 second I will get angry? कितना बार मैं बोलता हूँ यार, ये कुछ कोई जवाब नहीं ना, हमारा साइलेंट. मैं पूछता हूँ, मैं बोलता भी हूँ, मैं हमेशा क्वेश्चन आंसर का सेशन देता हूँ, बोलता भी हूँ, बट नोबडी पुट द क्वेश्चन इवन इन द चैट बॉक्स. ठीक है, आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट बोलने में प्रॉब्लम होता है. आई नो यू टोल्ड दैट वीडियो ऑन करने में नेटवर्क इशू होता है. मैंने कभी फोर्स नहीं किया. यू कैन पुट इन द चैट बॉक्स ऑल्सो ना, और यू डोंट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम ऑल्सो. मुझे इतना पेन लेने के लिए इसमें क्या जरूरत था लर्निंग आउटकम में. ओके, यस भनजा, या यू आर ट्रेलिंग समथिंग, यू आर ट्राइंग टू से समथिंग. हाँ, यस
सर, लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव इज बेसिकली द स्ट्रेटजीज व्हिच वी हैव टेकन फॉर लर्निंग समथिंग, टू लर्न समथिंग, टू एक्सपीरियंस समथिंग, बट द आउटकम when we get something and we apply those, that will be our outcome.
Okay,
that's also thing.
Anybody will try like to reply? Anybody else?
Sir, objective.
Yes.
Hello, me.
Sir, objective is we have to achieve it. Means we prepare the objective. Has to be plan prepare, but outcome is the product part.
Outcome is a product.
Whether the student can able to differentiate okay. Or explain or.
Okay. So there is a very clear cut distinction that I will tell. Because why I used to take this question, because from my experience I have observed that majority of the student, when I used to discuss about the learning objective and a learning outcome, people have this kind of a doubt. Okay, and the second thing is that when you will see the learning objective and a learning outcome, it will look like that same, because in the learning objective also we are trying to frame that through our teaching what I want to achieve, hai na? And the learning outcome also what the student will achieve. So it looks like same, but the clear cut distinction is that when we talk about the learning objective, it's teacher's perspective which is coming. It is a teacher's perspective. Means through your activity, through your teaching, what you want to achieve. it's a teacher's perspective. But when we talk about the learning outcome, it is perspective from the student. Means, okay, what I will do, that I will be doing. I have planned, I will execute. But out of all those exercises, what actually the student will do? And the next major distinction is that in order to achieve one learning outcome, you may need variety of learning objective. Variety of means, in order to achieve one learning outcome, you may need two or three or four, sometime one also, learning objective. So, learning outcome is somehow the broader goal, and the learning objective is the path through which we can achieve the learning outcome. Some outcome may be like that, through the one objective you can achieve that outcome. We will see with example, you can achieve those outcome. Some outcome may be like that, in order to achieve that you need multiple objective. So, objective is that path through which we can achieve the outcome. Objective suggests that what the teacher will be doing, and the outcome suggests what the student will be getting. So, basically two differences there. One is the difference of the perspective, another one is the outcome is a broader thing that can be achieved with the help of objectives. Okay, so that was that. Now we will see the learning objective at a elementary level. When you will see, this is the booklet. I will show the PDF and I will share the PDF also. So this is the learning outcome at a elementary stage. Just wait, I will share you. Are you able to see the screen?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, screen.
Abhi bhi nahi aaya. Abhi dekhiye, itna der mein to pahunch jana chahiye.
Ha, ha, ha. Yes, sir. Abhi
aaya. Ha. Because it takes some time. Okay. So, this is the... Ha, yes. So, this is the document, that is the learning outcome at elementary stage, and like that secondary stage document is also there, that I will show you. And when you will find this, this is the document which is prepared subject wise, class wise. Okay, so it is a subject wise, class wise document. And with in the start of this document, there are something point has been given, that as a curricular expectation, means through these exercise, through this means teaching learning exercise, what curricular expectations they have. See, whenever we talk about the outcome, okay, there are two types of outcome. One will be the curricular outcome, one will be the co-curricular outcome. Because when we have a teaching learning process in the school, both the things we emphasize. But since this document only talks about the curricular part, means this document is talking about that the learning outcome by teaching Hindi, English, mathematics, social science, like that. So, that's why they have given here only the curricular expectations. However, for the co-curricular thing, we have a different set of activities in the school. Okay, so that is not emphasized here. Only the outcome related to the curricular part is given here, and especially we are seeing now the learning outcome at a elementary level for mathematics. Other subjects are also given, but here we will see only mathematics in this class. So curricular expectation, you can easily see that what curricular expectations they have. This is the expectation, okay, means to develop a connection between daily life context and a mathematical thinking. And see, this curricular expectation will align with the aim that I was teaching, aim and objective of teaching mathematics at a elementary level and a secondary level. Because when we talk about the aim and objective, means we expect that these things will come out. So when we expect that these things will come out as a aim and objective of learning mathematics at a secondary level or elementary level, so this is nothing but the curricular expectations. Okay, so when I will read out this, you will find that there is a correlation, there is a linkage between these curricular expectations mentioned here and the learning aim and objective that we have discussed earlier. And that's why develop the connection between daily life context and a mathematical thinking. Means how the mathematical thinking, mathematization process happens and how the mathematics is being used in the daily life, the making a connection. Understand, shape and articulate their observable properties as similarities and differences among them. Means the different shape and size, like a 2D, 3D shape and size, and to articulate, to list down, to talk about the observable properties. Suppose that I am giving one cube. So what will be the observable properties? How many corners are there? How many edges are there? How many sides are there? Like that. Develop on method of performing operation on a number in a daily life, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So developing their own, I will show it by one example. So just wait 1 minute, time is also running, but let us see, we will see this by one example. When the system starts, let us discuss the another point. Develop language and a symbolic notation with standard algorithm of performing number operation. Means they will learn and develop the different language of mathematics and symbols used in mathematics to perform the day-to-day mathematical operation. Estimate outcome of operation on two or more number and use it in the daily life activity. Outcome of operation means whatever the things which we are doing, that includes the addition, subtraction kind of activity. So they will be able to estimate that what could be the number, like that. So I was talking about the, they will be able to develop their own method of performance. So just see, for example, are you able to see that whiteboard? I think you will not be able to see whiteboard. Are you able to see?
Yes sir, yes sir.
One minute
sir, abhi hat gaya,
sir abhi hat gaya.
Haan haan, hat gaya, hat gaya. Yes, I think now you must be able to see. See, the point of saying was that the children.
It is not there.
It is not
White screen
visible.
up, white screen up. No, sir. No, sir. Not yet.
Not
yet.
Okay. I think it should be visible because everything is fine, looking fine here. It's still not visible.
No, sir. No, sir.
1 minute. It is saying can't share your screen. Sorry for the error. Why can't say? 1 minute, 1 minute. I think now we must be able to see. Now, are you able to see now? Okay. So, we were talking about they will be able to devise their own methods of performing the mathematical operation. That means, suppose that I have given you to sum this 28 and 38, like that I have given to add these two number. So there are two student, okay, so both have been given these number to add. One will what to do, they will add 8 plus 8 is a 16, then one we will carry forward, and 2 plus 3 is 5, and one we have carried forward, so it will be 66. Another student, what they will do, they will say that, okay, so it is approaching to 30, so let it be 30, and this is approaching to 40, so let it be 40, and they will add it, this is a 70, and there is a less of 4 points, so 70 minus 4 is a 66. People also used to do calculate like that, and people also used to calculate like that, okay. So, both the type of a calculation is right, but it is the situation where you find the comfortable in calculating the things. Someone may be very much comfortable in calculating like that, but someone may be very comfortable in calculating like that and getting the answer. But it is not like that one or some of them is not correct. Both are correct, but by doing this method you can calculate the numbers very easily at a fast rate. So this is the method, and similarly that kind of a thing people also use while multiplying and while dividing, okay, so like that people used to do. So this I was trying to show you. Now, come to the learning outcome. So, that I was trying to say, other curricular expectations, just simply I will read because time is also approaching, that learn to represent the part of a whole as a fraction or order simple fraction, means suppose that there is a one part, suppose that the 50, so 50 is a part, so within the 50, suppose that I want to divide that 50 into 5 equal parts, so what will be the division, what will be the equal parts, that is the division. So like that, the curricular expectations are there. Now we will see the learning outcome and a pedagogical process class wise. All the learning outcome and a pedagogical process may not be able to cover here, but simply some of them we will see, and I will send this material to you. You can go through it and you can easily understand. Even though if you will feel any kind of a problem, you can ask me later on also. So like that, you can see that in a class 1 learning outcome that has been visualized is that classify object into group based on few physical attributes such as shape, size and other observable properties including rolling and sliding, recite number, name and counts object up to 20. Concurrently, pictorially and symbolically. So when we see that the mathematics at a class 1, it is not very distinct subject there, because within a book all the things and together with the mathematical concept you will find, and that's why it has been written that the sliding, rolling, so on the based upon those properties you can categorize the number. Categorization of a number means they will be able to count also. Suppose that I am categorizing based upon the shape. Suppose that those who are in the round shape. So I will one ball I will keep, another ball I will keep, another ball I will keep. So I will be counting also, and I will observe the shape and size also. So it will give the concept of a spatial thinking, that shape and size kind of a thinking, and the number also. And in the class 1, very basic things have been given, that is like the apply the addition and subtraction of a number 1 to 20 in a daily life. Like that, I have a 5 chocolate and my sister has given 2 more chocolates, so how many I have, like that, very simple. Okay, so what will be the pedagogical approach? Like that, the handle concrete material or a model and classify them, for example object which are round in shape such as the chapati, ball, etc. So the things which are used in our day-to-day life, like that, this type of again very basic. And here they will start the developing the concept of a zero. Concept of a zero will not develop here fully. Don't remember that they will be able to define the concept of a zero or a concept of any number, but they will be able to recognize that nothing I have, or 5 chocolate I have, or 5 shirts I have, like that. They will not able to define the number, what is the number, like that when I ask or when I discuss and you reply. So that kind of a reply won't come, but they will start developing the sense that how much, how many they have. And gradually when see the class 2, you will find that they will be able to now read and write the numerals and the numbers up to 99, sorry. Then they represent the amount up to 100 rupees, 100, using the 3-4 notes and a coin. Like that, I have given 5 coin of 5 notes of 20 rupees. So how many it will be, like that. When you will see the class 3 mathematics, now it will be read and write number up to 99. There it was up to 100 only. Now it is up to 999, means up to 1000. Compare the number up to 1000, like that. When you will, now you will see the class 4, gradually it will increase. Apply operation of a number in daily life, multiply 2 to 3 digits number. Now they will be able to multiply. Hana? Converts meter into centimeter and vice versa. Conversion of a different measurement, unit of measurement. Like that, when you will see the class 5, now they will be able to write the bigger number than 1000, hai na? And this you can see, I will send you. When you, that was the primary, now it is the upper primary, means class 6, 7 and 8. So solve problem involving large number by applying appropriate operation, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. See, before that we have given a specific operation, like to divide or to multiply or to add, subtract, kind of a thing. But here now they will be able to decide, in order to solve problem, what is required, and they will be able to do a multiple operation, may require a multiple operation. LCF and HCF, the concept of LCM and LCF, LCM and HCF, they will develop like that. So like that, these are the learning outcome at elementary level. Like that you can see that at class 8, multiply algebraic expression, and side by side you will see the, this is the suggested pedagogical process also. See, the outcome is generalize properties of addition and subtraction, multiplication and division of a rational number through patterns. So this is the outcome you want. Okay, so in order to have that outcome or ensure that outcome, what kind of a pedagogical process you may adapt? Explore example of rational numbers with all the operations and explore pattern in these operation. Use generalized form of a number up to 3 digit and use her understanding of algebra to derive the divisibility rule for 3, 2, 3, 4, done earlier by observing pattern on them. Like that, the pedagogical approach is also given. Now we will see the this one. This is the learning outcome at a secondary level. So like that, the curriculum expectations also they have framed. See, the curriculum expectation that was earlier was very basic. Now when the curricular expectations you will see at a secondary level, it will be based upon the nature of mathematics, like the developing a higher order thinking process in mathematics, ability to think logically, formulate and handle abstraction, like that. Mathematical vocabulary, increasing mathematical vocabulary, because the secondary education mathematics is to prepare the child for the higher mathematics or for the learning other discipline like a physics, chemistry and biology, like that kind of a thing. So it will be based upon that. Now you can see the learning outcome, that the learner applies the logical reasoning in classifying the real number, providing their properties and using them in different situation. And it is like that, you will find, relate the algebraic and a graphical representation of a linear equation in one or a two variable. Like that, the learning outcome is framed. So I will send this, and you can go through, and you can, if you have any doubt later on also, you can talk to me, discuss to me. So we will have this session up to here only, and in the next class we will see the next thing which is in our syllabus. That is the curriculum reforms, like that kind of a things which we have in our syllabus, that we will see. So any question up to here, any kind of a doubt or a question, if you have, you can now just ask me any doubt or a question.
Yeah. हेलो सर, हेलो सर,
हाँ यस हम यो यस
सर, हम जो पहले जो लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव जो डिसाइड करते हैं वो हम कोर्स कंटेंट को देख के डिसाइड कर देते हैं, तो बाद में जब हम कंटेंट बढ़ा के खत्म हो जाता है तो बाद अप टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव आर completed, learning the objects are achieved, that will be
okay.
The outcome.
Yes. That will be outcome out of your teaching. See, outcome that I have talked here have a little bit different perspective. I will repeat it again. But whatever you have told that we have framed the objective and as per the objective we have prepared all the thing. We have delivered that lesson also based upon the prepared objective. And out of the delivery of the lesson, what the children have learned. So, that is the outcome out of your engagement, learning engagement. Because you have engaged in the learning situation and out of your engagement, what they have achieved, that is the learning outcome out of your teaching. But here the learning outcome which I am talking had a little bit a broader perspective. Broader in the sense that you are talking only on the basis of your lesson, means whatever you have engaged and what they have achieved. I am talking here holistically, means what they should achieve. That's why when you have I have shown you the document, you have must have find that they have devised the outcome for a class wise. Means once a child is passing one class, suppose that the child is being promoted from 3 to 4, okay. So, up to 3, what kind of the outcome they must have, what kind of a skill they must have, what kind of a knowledge they must have, means what is expected to have by the child at a particular stage of learning. Yes, you are right that you have engaged them and whatever they have learned, that is the outcome. But here the outcome I am talking, so the child, when the child will go from one class to another class, what the child is expected to have, what the child is supposed to have. Suppose that the child is going from class 3 to 4. So, what kind of a knowledge, what kind of a skill, what kind of attitude the child must have, what kind of understanding the child must have. So, that is the outcome which is discussed here. Yes, is it clear to you, Amir?
Yes, sir.
So, some message was also there in the chat. The outcome will be different for each. No. See, whatever Amya has said that when I will discuss in the class and the child will learn something. So, that outcome will be different for the every child. May be different, may be same also, based upon the degree of learning they have had. Okay. But the kind of learning outcome I talked here, it is expected that it will be same for everybody, because when I am promoting a child, suppose a 10 child I have from 4 to 5, so I may not have a different criteria for each. I will expect that all will know the same skill, all will have a same understanding, all will develop the same attitude. So, the learning outcome which is visualized here is the same for every child. And that's why it is not very much exhaustive. Matlab, everything is not covered. It covers only the very essential thing which is very much required. Suppose that a child has come to a class 5 and don't know the counting of a number from 1 to 1000. It will be difficult. So, every child who have came to class 5 are expected to have a counting of numbers up to 1000. So these are the mandatory. And, 1 minute. So those mandatory things are listed here. It is not very much exhaustive, because if you don't know, so you are not supposed to promote it, because it will create again the difficulty in the learning the higher level of a concept. Yes, please tell what you was telling, Vanija.
Sir, in a particular class, there will be students of various standards. My expectation cannot be fulfilled for all.
Yes, you are right that in a particular class, suppose that for sake of example, class 5, a student from the various ability will be there. And that's why I am repeatedly saying that this list, this list is not exhaustive. This list has listed the very essential. Suppose that there are a variety of people and they have a variety of ability. Okay, so every person may not be able to do every work. I may not expect also, but when I will list down the quality, the ability to survive in this world, there are some criteria. If you will fulfill, then only you will be able to survive. If you are not fulfilling, you won't be able to survive. And when we talk about the learning outcome like this, this document suggests the essential things you must know in order to go to the higher class. All of them will not have a same achievement level. I agree. But basic, which is very basic in nature, suppose that you remember your class or your B.Ed. class also, when the test will be conducted, all of you will secure a same mark? No, you won't secure. Even in the plus 2, plus 3, matric, 9, 10th, all of you have secured the same mark? No. But in order to go in the higher class, some minimum criteria is there that you must be having. So those minimum criteria is listed here. Means you must know. Yes, tell me. Yes, question somebody was trying to ask. I have interrupted them.
Yes, sir.
Achha.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, we used to expect, but all time our expectation not fulfilled.
Not fulfilled, that may be another another thing. Okay, something is in message also. So, it will be different for each class, not for each children. Yes, it will be different for the class wise, because ye very basic wala hai na, it is not very much exhaustive. It is a basic, you must have, hai na, 4 to 5 mein ja rahe hai, then something you must have na, that is a minimum. I am not saying that all children will have all the things, no. I have a expect learning outcome should develop in all child. Yes, it should be developed. That is why it is a very basic in nature. That should be developed each child. Whether the child is securing 90 mark or whether the child is securing 50 mark. Sir, like learning objective, learning outcome is a prepared before teaching, true or false? Yes, we prepare it well before. See, teaching learning to chal raha hai na. Ye to pahle se idhar prepare ho karke rakha hai. कि वट एवर आप पढ़ाएं, वट एवर यू आर टीचिंग, यू मस्ट अचीव दिस लर्निंग आउटकम. ठीक है, टू हूम यू आर टीचिंग, वट आर द मेथड यू आर अडेप्टिंग, और वट एवर द थिंग, यू मस्ट अचीव दिस लर्निंग आउटकम. इट इज अ वेल बिफोर प्रिपेयर्ड. ओके, सो आई थिंक नाउ वी शुड स्टॉप दिस सेशन हियर. अदर डाउट एंड डाउट्स वी विल बी talking in the next class also, because it is 9:56 and you are supposed to join the other classes also. So,